Hi, I'm Vicki Quisenberry, Executive Director of the Foundation for Daviess County Public Schools, and I want to thank you for joining us for Enhancing Education Through the Foundation. Today we're at the River Park Center. I'm with my friend Paul Karem, and we are here to tell you all about our Black and Blue Dinner in a Movie event coming up July 27th and 28th. Paul, I've got a really hard question for you. Why this movie? Why this film?
Well, Vicki, as it turns out, that's not a hard question at all. This movie is about a story that has been waited to be told for 50 years. This movie is about four remarkable American heroes who broke the color barrier in the Southeastern Conference in sports. And I think that one of the reasons it hadn't been told for 50 years is because of the remarkable humility of these young men. A quality that's not evident a lot today in society, and they have never in any way called for attention to be drawn to their remarkable achievement. So we're making a film, Black and Blue, about the men who broke the color barrier in sports in the Southeastern Conference. Truly one of the great steps toward integration in the Southern United States.
Do you think as 18 and 19-year-old college students they had any idea how historic what they were doing was?
Great question, and I think if you watch the film that they had some sense of it, although some of the fellas, including Houston Hogg from right here in Owensboro, just wanted to play football. I'm not sure they knew what kind of a grist mill they were going into. But once there, they knew what they were doing, and they were men that were capable of the challenge, mm-hmm. and then some.
Yeah.
And our film is going to tell the whole story.
Yeah, this is just a phenomenal story. I know I mentioned to you before, I'm not a huge football fan, but this story just absolutely enthralls me. I think it's just a phenomenal story, and I'm really excited to see the movie. You've told me multiple times how good it is. So I know you and Paul Wagner were at UK together. Paul is a UK graduate, just like you are. Can you tell us a little bit about your all's friendship and why Paul Wagner to make this film?
Well, Paul Wagner is a graduate from University of Kentucky. He was at U of K when the things that the film are about happened, including tragedy and triumph. And Paul Wagner, I still haven't figured out how this happened, just happens to be an Academy Award-winning filmmaker, and he's my partner on this film.
Right, so
there could not be another human being better fitted to tell this story, and Paul's made about 50 films.
Mm-hmm. Well, and not only Academy Awards, but I went to his website the other day, and he has won award after award after award. But you were telling me after you saw the film that it really tells the story in a compelling way. You were mentioning how it focuses on each of the players individually and then them together as teammates. Can you elaborate on that just a little bit?
Tells the story of each of them, their perspective, their experience, their wondrous accomplishment, the effect of the bonding of the teammates. This would be a good time to mention that one of the men, Wilber Hackett, was the first African-American captain of any athletic team in the Southeastern Conference, elected by 100 white men, but his teammates. Mm-hmm. But the bigger piece of the film is the historic data and trivia and the historical pieces that Paul has uncovered about how it came to pass that the other schools in the SEC elected to play an integrated Kentucky team, and more and more and more. And again, as you mentioned at the beginning, Lincoln Bridge is doing the music. Mm-hmm. Anybody that's heard Lincoln Bridge on America's Got Talent or any of the other venues they've been on, if you can watch Lincoln Bridge, a black a cappella group from Louisville, sing My Old Kentucky Home without shedding a tear, something's wrong with you.
And they have they created the musical score for this movie.
Original music score for the movie in studio as the film was playing. Paul would tell them, and Paul has a musical background as well. Mm-hmm. This is what we need to do here. I need a melody with a close, whatever kind of vernacular musicians use. It's terrific.
And you called me from the taping of the music, and you were just overwhelmed by the quality of the music in the film. And you also mentioned something else to me. I just have absolutely loved getting to know Houston Hogg through this process. He's got quite the personality.
Houston is something else, and he tells some of the stories of some of the stuff that he went through, mm-hmm. when we played together. And people in Owensboro that know Houston know that He's had 200 foster children mm-hmm. that he's foster parented that have lived in his home. And Owensboro was the ground for a lot of our great teammates at UAK, Tom Clark, Tom Crow, Paul Martin, Paul Puckett, Fred Hamburg, all these guys were from Owensboro well. So when Houston came from Owensboro, everybody knew he could play football.
Absolutely.
And he could.
Yeah, yeah. You know, you mentioned a few minutes ago Lincoln Bridge. How did you, as executive producer of this film, and Paul Wagner as the filmmaker, how did you all choose Lincoln Bridge to do the music? Why them?
Crazy story. One of the businesses that I own, one of my operational people that has helped with the formation of that business, which is a customer service training and consulting company, is Ben Lawrence. Ben's sister is Jennifer Lawrence. The Jennifer Lawrence Foundation has been a supporter of the film, and they connected us up with Lincoln Bridge. So that's how
wow.
that happened.
Wow. And you've told me that it's just such a great partnership.
It's absolutely perfect.
It's
absolutely perfect. And the thing that comes through with these gentlemen, these young men with Lincoln Bridge, that's so similar to these four black heroes, is their discipline, their intent way to make every note perfect. I was in studio with them the day I called you when mm-hmm. I was swept off my feet. And they would go over one sentence in a song 40 or 50 times.
Just to get
before
it perfect.
They had it the way they wanted it to sound, and all 40 sounded the same to me. So mm-hmm. just terrific young men, and okay. they're going to be big.
Okay. So we've got an Academy Award-winning filmmaker in Paul Wagner, and you've agreed to MC the event for us that evening, so folks will
forced
be able to see you.
I didn't agree to it. I was forced.
I drug you into it, didn't
That's
I?
That's right.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll admit to that. So we have you. We have Paul Wagner. The three gentlemen that are still living are going to be here. Excited to have them in Owensboro, and then Greg Page's brother is going to be here as well. Very excited to have these folks. We've gotten phenomenal support from UK Alumni Association. We're glad to have our Daviess County Club involved in that as well. Paul Martin has been a big supporter working with us on this. You mentioned him as a teammate. So we're very excited about this event, the Black and Blue Dinner and a Movie event that will be here in Owensboro. Now, this is the first time this preview will be shown.
This is the first
The very
preview.
First showing will be right here in Owensboro at the River Park Center. VIP reception, moonlight catered dinner, and a previewing for up to 1,500 people in Cannon Hall here at River Park Center on July 27th and 28th. You can contact OwensboroTickets.com for ticketing information. You can call me at 270-231-5583 to talk about sponsorship opportunities. Or you could email me at Vicky Q, that's V-I-C-K-I-Q, at foundationfordcps.org. And we are looking forward to seeing you at the end of July. Have a great day.